come out of my house, like I put on my headphones, start listening, I get on the train, I leave it on sometimes, like, even when I'm studying, and then like sometimes I fall asleep, the whole time is still on.
While I'm walking out of my apartment, I usually turn on the music and I just listen to it all the way until I get to work.
I get out of the house as I'm walking towards school and the station. Somewhere along there, when I feel right, I'm just gonna take out my headphones and start listening whatever music I had on.
The second that I leave my house, I have my iPod in my hand, and then I put my earphones on and get on the elevator and press play and listen to music the entire ride here.
And I remember everything, everything I loved, I gave it away like it wasn't enough.
It's just something like keep you in your own little bubble, you know? You get kind of like to escape from the, I guess, like all those chaotic sounds when you're walking around.
Well, you see a lot of other people doing it, and I don't know, I just, most of the time in the morning, I just don't want to hear anything other than just music. It's just kind of wake me up.
I also like the fact that I can be in my own world, block everything out except what I want to listen to.
Anywhere where I can listen to music, I do. I think it's because I'm a New Yorker, I'm not used to silence. So while I'm on the commute, it's kind of the same thing. I want to surround myself with sounds, and I would like to be in control of what they are.
I hate people coming up to me when I'm on my way somewhere, and it's easier to avoid them or to just ignore them when you're listening to music. If you have your headphones on, people tend not to want to bother you.
Guys on the street who say obnoxious things and hit on you. So I've noticed if you listen to music or you have headphones on, they will be less likely to bother you.
Oh yeah, of course. I mean, I think every girl does that. Half the time when I do have my earphones on and if a guy says something to me, I just pretend like my music was so loud that I didn't hear them.
Well, I guess in the city you kind of have to, because there's so many things going on. You don't want to, if you pay attention to everything, you'll kind of go nuts.
I think because there are so many people in New York, I mean, if you tried to have a conversation every time you saw somebody, you wouldn't have time to do anything else.
Yeah, it's a city thing. Definitely city thing. I mean, your city's like Tokyo, Japan. Yeah, I assume like maybe like 9 out of 10 people use the iPods. Can I say
listening to music as you travel can make you antisocial in the sense that you're not really communicating with anybody. You're in your own world, and if everybody's doing that, then you're not going to have the opportunity to communicate with people. But you're traveling. Who cares?
Whatever makes the train ride pass faster, you know, more pleasant.
Sometimes you need it to get to a certain place. You know what I mean? If it's a four-hour like bus ride, hey, you know, it's good to have your tunes with you. You know, something to keep you occupied.
I guess the commute's kind of tiring sometimes, commuting to school, so it just speeds up time faster, because it's not like you're driving where you have to focus on the road or something. It's just you walking around.
If my iPod dies, I feel horrible, and I'm very bored and miserable, and the train ride is like an hour and a half, and it's horrible.
I hate when my iPhone dies or when I leave my headphones at home, which happens a lot. I've actually bought pairs of headphones on the way to wherever I was going so that I could listen to my music.
I used to listen to music before my iPod broke, and it was awesome. You know, time went by really fast, like 4 or 5 songs. It would be a whole commute over here. Just the sound of the trains and like people's conversations and the boom, boom, you know, on the train, it's like it's its own music in itself, you know, so I appreciate that a little bit more.
Clear out the closing doors, please.